My name is Allison Long, and welcome to this week's USF Health Brief, once again looking at the continuing effects of COVID-19. Today, I welcome Dr. Kevin Sneed, Dean of USF Health's Taneja College of Pharmacy, to discuss the pharmacist's role in this pandemic. Welcome, Dr. Sneed.
Thank you.
How has the Taneja College of Pharmacy helped find medications that treat COVID-19?
From the beginning of the outbreak, we've really been engaged here both within USF and outside around the country. A lot of people don't know COVID-19 can actually infect the eye. And so right now we're developing a medication that can be an eye drop with one of the very early medications that kind of showed efficacy, a medication called remdesivir.
A common steroid has made headlines recently as a way to potentially reduce lung inflammation. How promising of a treatment is this for COVID-19?
The medication you're talking about is called dexamethasone. It's an anti-inflammatory medication that normally we inject into joints. It can actually shut down the inflammation that does begin to build in the lungs secondary to some patients being infected with COVID-19. And it has been shown in clinical trials right now to be very effective at reducing that inflammation and allowing the body to actually recover, and thereby allowing the patient to recover a little bit quicker. It will not prevent the infection, but should you move on to having a very high inflammatory internal state because of COVID-19, this has been shown to be a very effective medication.
Okay, and it's relatively inexpensive.
This medication has been around, dexamethasone has been around for a very long time. So it comes generically, very inexpensive, easy to make. So we're very, very high on the potential for that medication to treat a lot of patients moving into the future.
So how do you think the COVID-19 pandemic will affect how the U.S. healthcare system sources its medication going forward?
Right now, we are really afraid that the COVID-19 pandemic has really shown weaknesses in our medication distribution system. And therefore, one way to overcome that would be to bring back safely the manufacturing of medications here to the United States. But we have a lot of technology and companies that really they really want to bring that manufacturing back here. And so I'm very confident that that can occur. But COVID-19 really did kind of reveal a little bit of the weakness in our system in terms of medication distribution.
How have pharmacists used telehealth to treat patients?
Right here at USF Health, we have a pharmacy called USF Health Pharmacy Plus. And we've been using telehealth now for about a 5-year period. And when the COVID pandemic hit, it really became a really primary means of being able to communicate face-to-face with a patient right there on your mobile phone. I'm really proud of what USF Health overall was capable of doing. We stood up a telehealth platform in almost no time at all. And so now even our clinical pharmacist team that is collaborating with both the Department of Family Medicine and our general internal medicine group, we have pharmacists that work along with those medical teams, and we've been collaborating and meeting with patients by telehealth to go over their diabetes, to see how the conditions are doing, make sure they have their refills on medications, and really just to make sure the medications are working. So telehealth here for USF Health has been outstanding. I believe it will be here to stay, and clearly our pharmacy, our College of Pharmacy here has been a key and integral part of helping foster telehealth here at USF Health.
Do you think this COVID-19 pandemic has helped introduce students to the field of pharmacy, or has more enrollment gone up?
The COVID-19 situation really has begun to show people how important it can be to have a trained clinical pharmacy specialist on your team. And really no other program, in my estimation, is really more positioned or better positioned than our program here at USF Health than to train people to be able to go out there and both take on a pandemic like COVID-19, the chronic disease states that are still a problem, or even the futuristic things that we have yet to encounter, and we're teaching them how to deal with the ambiguity of tomorrow. And so when you deal with all of that together, it really does kind of spell out that pharmacy is a very good profession to come into, and the COVID-19 situation really has begun to kind of highlight the benefits of having a trained clinical pharmacist around. If unique is what you seek, you should come to the Taneja College of Pharmacy.
Well, thank you, Dr. Sneed, so much for being with me today.
But thank you very much. I really enjoyed our time.
Thank you for spending time with us today. And please tune in next Tuesday when Freddie Coleman talks to USF Health medical student Tampa Hutchins about how COVID-19 is affecting medical education from the student's perspective.